You know, these spool guns are heavy, big, bulky. Can't really get them in a tight spot like this is in. So I'm trying to make this weld here with these two obstacles here with the spool gun. I don't see this being real easy, if I can make the weld. Can't get the right angle at it. So welcome to Weld.com. Today we have a guest speaker from Abicor Binzel. His name is Zach. How you doing, Zach? Nice to meet you.
Thanks for having me.
Anytime. So we're going to talk about some aluminum mid-gun welding and the difficulties. And Zach is going to solve all these difficulties with his new FreedomDrive.
Yeah, so this is a new design that we have here. It's a combination of existing items or existing ideas with the comfortability of having a regular mid-gun at the front. And we'll go ahead and start from the wire feeder end here. So rear cables, they come in two different lengths. We get 14 feet and 24 foot lengths. They come equipped with direct hookups for majority of your wire feeders, your standard wire feeders, and it has all your internal lines and everything that you need in order to weld, and covered by this durable leather cover.
I like the leather boot that covers all the cables and everything, so when you do drag it across the floor or steel or anything, it doesn't arc out or doesn't crimp the cable or rip the insulation off the cable or anything.
So, next major component we have is the main drive module. So inside we have a pull motor that'll help assist that wire being fed through the torch, which, as you know, with aluminum wire, right, softer wires, it can be an absolute pain to do, yep, over longer distances.
So that solves a lot of the bird nesting and everything that you have in aluminum mid-gun welding.
Exactly. So without this secondary drive, you're going to be constantly going back to your wire feeder, fixing your bird's nesting.
Right.
All sorts of wire bunching.
Correct.
And wasting a lot of time doing so. We have a green jog switch or wire inch button, and this is predominantly to help with the setup of the entire system to make sure that once engaged, you can go ahead and feed wire through the entirety of the gun. And once you're done in your setup phase where you've got it selected to your tension that you're trying to get, you can go ahead and close the slide cover here. And this keeps dirt and debris free from your drive rolls and make sure that there's no foreign matter that comes into your system.
Especially something that can get in there and stop the rollers and stop everything up. And,
right.
You know, another difficult problem that y'all solved, you know, which,
yep,
is another great feature.
Yep. But with also being transparent, if that were to ever happen, you can actually see directly where,
right,
the issue is.
Where the issue is.
So we have what we call a range switch selector. It consists of three stages. You have a low, medium, and high setting. And by toggling this switch, you're able to get a certain range of wire feed speed from the actual welder itself. So rather than moving back to the actual wire feeding, right, machine, you can go ahead and adjust that range just from this module right here. We got these eyelets here. There may be certain applications here where you're, say, somewhere in the air, you need a little bit more reach, and having the motor on the ground is actually not beneficial to you. So,
correct,
we've provided a couple clasps here that can be suspended in the air or towards any sort of fixture to help give you the little extra distance that you may need.
So you can hang it on a scaffold board.
Exactly.
You know, if you're up there working on a scaffolding or anything, you can hang it up there. That's another great feature.
So I guess we can go ahead and move to the front torch section. This is a 6-foot lightweight torch. Call this the Abimeg AT line. And here, I'll let you go ahead and hold that.
That is very light.
Yeah.
I like the swivel too.
Yep. Ball joint allows for a little bit more maneuverability. Comes with an ergonomic style handle. So,
right,
for easy comfort.
It is very lightweight, and for me, MIG welding in the past, I don't like them big, heavy, bulky guns, you know, because there's no flexibility or anything, but this thing's very flexible, comfortable, you know, fits right in your hand. It's not real big and bulky. It's very light, and it fits your hand just right.
Right. Yep, that was the whole idea, is make a push-pull torch with the comfortability of a regular MIG torch.
Right. And then we have rheostat?
Yep, so we got another knob here, potentiometer knob up top, which works in conjunction with your range switch selector in the drive system. But this is just to help dial in more effectively your wire feed speed
right.
without having to go back to the wire feeder again.
How about this head?
Yep, so we have a lock nut here that secures the torch neck in place. And when loosened, you can actually rotate it around a full 360 degree. Mm-hmm. There is a locked key system in the mating portion of this torch neck
right.
so that you can adjust it in any slot that you see fit for any application.
It's very convenient too, because I mean, it's very simple to use, operate, and it's got like, what, six or seven positions you can use. And just like you said, it goes 360 degrees. It's very versatile.
Yes.
Very versatile.
And this is not the only option that you have as far as torch necks go. We have different geometries, different lengths, different bend angles. We also offer a flex neck. So depending on the welder's circumstance and their job, we have their needs covered as far as their torch neck goes.
So I'm excited to try it out.
Let's give it a go.
Let's do it. So what we're going to use today with the Freedom Drive, we're going to use the Bowler 4043 aluminum spool wire, which has an AWS spec of 5.10 with an 047 diameter. Wow, that was great. I really like this MIG gun with the flexibility that it has over a conventional big old bulky spool gun, and everything at your fingertips right here to control it all, your wire speed, your volts, and it's very well thought out.